Hi everyone, and welcome back to a new video. Today I'm reading to you Sharing a Room, written by Dot Meharry, illustrated by John Bennett. Sharing a room. Right where the door's peeking open, you can see it says Bella's room and Sophie's room. Bella and her twin sister Sophie shared a big bedroom. Bella's side of the room was always neat. Everything was in its place. Sophie's side of the room was usually messy. There were things on the bed and all over the floor. This girl's very neat and organized. This girl is very messy and pretty creative. Bella liked reading. She also liked to draw. She kept her pens in a box and her paper in a drawer. Her desk was never messy. Sophie liked playing guitar. She also liked collecting and making things. Often she had feathers, leaves, and shells all over her desk. One morning, Bella and Sophie both felt grumpy. "You're too messy," Bella said to Sophie. "Your things are all over the place." "You're too neat," replied Sophie. "Your things are always in the same place." "I like my things the way they are," said Bella. "I like my things the way they are too," said Sophie. Looks like we're pretty grumpy today. Sophie got out her skipping rope and put it on the floor between the beds. "What are you doing?" asked Bella. "This is my side of the room," said Sophie. "And that's your side." The skipping rope didn't help. Bella and Sophie were still grumpy. I can still see your mess," Bella complained. "We need a wall down the middle of the room." "Yes, but we don't have a wall," said Sophie. "I have an idea. We can make one," said Bella, and she walked out of the bedroom. I wonder what they're up to. Bella got some cardboard boxes from the shed. She and Sophie worked together to stack them. Soon they'd made a wall of boxes right down the middle of the room. Bella stayed on her side of the boxes. She read her new book quietly. Sophie stayed on her side of the book. Boxes and she played her guitar softly. Bella started drawing a picture. Sophie started making a caterpillar. They didn't feel grumpy anymore, but they didn't feel happy either. They both felt lonely. Bella looked at the wall of boxes. She wished she could play. She could watch Sophie play her guitar. She wished she could see what Sophie was making. Sophie looked at the wall of boxes. She wished she could see Bella's new book. And she wished she could see what Bella was drawing. Looks like they're feeling pretty lonely now. "I miss you," Sophie called Bella as she took down one of the boxes. "I miss you too," Sophie replied. "Let's get rid of the boxes." "Great idea," said Bella. They took the boxes back to the shed. Bella put some drawings on Sophie's side of the room. Sophie puts leaves and feathers on Bella's side. Then they moved the furniture. They put their chairs side by side. Bella read her book. Sophie played her guitar, and the boxes stayed in the shed. I'm going to read the blurb to you now. Bella and Sophie are twins, but they are very different. Sharing a room isn't always easy for them. I hope you enjoyed Sharing a Room. Before you go, don't forget to like and subscribe to this video. Bye!